So today we start with the topic exercise 1.2. Before starting the exercise, I just want to introduce what are the irrational numbers and what are the real numbers. Irrational numbers are those numbers in which we can't write in a form of p by q. That means those numbers which are not represented by p by q form. Those numbers are called irrational numbers, where p and q are integers and q are not equal to 0. For example, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7, pi, etc. These all are kind of irrational number. What are real numbers? The collection of all rational numbers and irrational numbers together are called the real numbers. It is denoted by a letter capital R. That means real number contain both the rational and irrational number. On the other way, we can say real number are those number which contain natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational, irrational. That means which contain all kind of the numbers are called irrational number. Every real number is represented on the number line. That means we can represent a unique real number is represented on the number line. We can easily represent the any real number on the number line. There are so many methods are there. We will discuss on later. First we start with the exercise 1.2. So this is your exercise 1.2. State whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. First part is every irrational number is a real number. As we know that real number contain all kinds of the irrational number, so this statement is true. Yes, real number contain both the number rational and irrational, so that's why irrational number is a real number. Second part is every point on the number line is a form of root m, where m is a natural number. That means we can represent every point in the form of root m. That it means any number you can take from the natural number you can represent in the form of root m. Now see, this statement is false. If I take minus 2, it is also a real number, but its square root is not any rational number, like root 4 gives the, and it is a square root of 2, so 2 is a natural number. But minus root 2 having a no root, so that's why we can't represent any number in the form of root m, where m is a natural number. Now next is every real number is a irrational number. That means you have to show that every real number is a irrational number. This statement is false, like 2 is a real number, but it is not a irrational number, because it is not a irrational number. Irrational numbers are like a form of under root of 2, under root of 3, under root of 5, but 2 is a real number, so it cannot be written in the form of p by q, so it is not a irrational number. That means every real number is not a irrational number. Next is, are the square root of all positive integers are irrational? If not, give an example of square root of a number that is a rational number. That means you want to show, he want to say that square root of every positive integer is a irrational. If it is not, then give a example. You have to give a one example which represents the square root of the number is a rational number. See, no, square root of the all the positive integers are not irrational. Let us suppose root 4, its square root is 2, that is 2 by 1 is a rational number, but it is not a irrational because we have to represent in form of p by q, so that's why it is not a form of irrational numbers. Draw the irrational numbers on the number line. For this we will start with the, this is the extra one, root 2. How to draw a root 2 on the number line? For this I will write in the form of 1 square plus 1 square, that is equal to 1 plus 1, this is equal to root 2. Using the Pythagoras theorem, we can make the root 2 on the number line. Now see how to represent root 2 on the number line. First you have to make a line of any length. Let line be AB. Now take any O point over here and consider it a 0. then mark 1 unit distance from O. Let it be C. This is a 1 unit. Now make a 90-degree angle at point C. Even you can draw with the help of compass, but I am taking with the help of protractor. This is the 90-degree. Now join the point with C. So this is your 90-degree angle. After that, open your compass 1 centimeter. Put at C and mark one arc. After that, join the point D and O. Now by using, this is a right angle triangle, by using Pythagoras theorem, this is a root 2, because this is base, this is perpendicular. Base square plus perpendicular square having square root gives hypotenuse. Now open your compass according to the length of OD. Now put at O and mark an arc. This point will represent, this E point will represent root 2 on the number line. In this way you can represent root 2 on the number line. Now next is represent root 3 on the number line. For this we have to draw root 2 on the number line. Now I want to draw root 3 on the number line. Similarly, we will use the Pythagoras theorem. Now see, I can write into root 2 square plus 1 square. This is equal to root square is 2, 1 square is 1. It is equal to root 3. That means I will take one it as a base and second one as a perpendicular. Now see, first you have to draw root 2 on the number line. Then after that you can draw root 3 on the number line. Now see, this is already we have done root 2 on the number line. You have to make again root 2 on the number line. Then after that you will use that root 2 for making root 3. Now put your protector at point D, like in this way, and make a 90-degree. This is the 90-degree. Put your compass over, put your pinpoint over here, then join. So this is your base, this is your perpendicular, this is 90-degree angle. After that, similarly, already root 2 is a base. Now you have to open 1 centimeter compass and mark on this 90-degree. This is 1 centimeter. Mark an arc, let it be this point is F. Now join this point with O. Open your compass according to the length of OF. Then similarly open according to the length of OF. You have to see. Now mark an arc. This arc, this G point represent root 3. This is root 2 and this is root 3. In this way you can draw root 4, root 5, root 6 and root 7. Similarly you can draw. Now next is your question is question number 2, draw root 5 on the number line. Now see how we will draw root 5 on the number line. Now see, I want to draw root 5 on the number line. Root 5 can be, we can write in this way, 4 plus 1. 4 is a square of 2, that is 2 square, plus as it is 1 is a square of 1. This is equal to root 5. In this way, that means one side I will take 2 and one side I will take 1 centimeter and join that line. After that, I will open the compass according to the length of the root 5 and represent on the number line. Now see how to draw the root 5 on the number line. Similarly, you have to take any length first. This is O. O dash, let it be any point A on the number line, let it be a 0 point. Then mark 2 centimeter here. This is 2 centimeter point, let it be B. Then after that make a 90 degree angle on the B point. This is 90 degree. Now you have to open your compass 1 centimeter. This is accurate 1 centimeter. Mark an arc. Let it be this point will be C. Join A and C. This is 1 centimeter and this represent root 5. Now open your compass according to the length of AC. This is according to the length of AC. Now put your compass over here and mark an arc. This D point represent root 5 on the number line. So in this way you can represent any number, any square root number on the number line.